Well, there's a lot of people. You feel one thing, they feel another.
So what? It's Speaker's Corner. It's Speaker's Corner. It doesn't matter. It's Speaker's Corner. It does matter. It does matter.
Because
I am harassing crime. Oh, I'm so offended. He's harassing crime. So can you please practice
she's provoking them, they're not provoking us.
Well, they've just pointed to us, but they're here for something, so you shouldn't be here.
Yeah, but you don't want the woman to speak.
Come over.
They've just spoken to you earlier today already, I know this. They've very quickly told you they do not want to debate me. I could tell that within seconds of being here that you
were.
It doesn't mean they have to debate
me. Of course they don't, but I have had to ask my questions.
That's what the court is about, to speak and debate.
That's what I'm going on for years, and
that's what's made Speaker's Court. Okay.
What I care is about this specific public order situation here, which I'm trying to present.
Which is not the rules by hand.
Well, come on, fingers got to the attack.
So I saw some of you were watching from a distance, and you didn't come in, because she was standing there silent. And I think when you walked out, you suddenly
thought,
you know what? But it was only when she walked away.
She actually says she approached us and wanted to talk to
that wouldn't be what we'd have had to do, would it?
We'd have
to
force
our way into the secret land scenario in
the
I'm not half a shot down.
Well, what's happening now?
Not a lot.
It's because
we're going to be off. Nothing happens. Unless there is a rabid, violent mob that will attack us.
I don't know.
We are in the dangerous area. 5, 6, 7. Which is where the brakes are. Just be within the round.
Well, you're clearly very more familiar with this place than me.
Well, that possibly does.
Technically, you're not familiar with this.
No, but I am familiar with
this situation. Yeah, I know that it's completely different. And Steve Barnes, the resident officer of Speaker's Corner, has produced a training plan for you guys. So you do understand the realities. They've gumption that Steve Barnes, the nominated officer for Speaker's Corner, produced. He's retiring now, so he's not here. He spent years here. He knew how to handle it down to a fine art, and he's produced.
Well, I'm here now, and I'm handling it this way.
And he used to be in the TSG, so you know he's not some naive, gullible police officer. But he knows how to police this. So you are, but you are showing some naivety when it comes to Speaker's Corner, because some guys came up to you and said she's causing problems. You have faith in her.
Yes.
I feel that guy is causing problems.
We said they cause a problem. Would you believe us?
I see what was going on at the time. Potentially, yes.
Yeah. Did you say
all of us have a hatred for Hatton?
What did you say?
I saw this lady in the middle of the crowd that clearly did not want her there.
Because I have the hatred for Hatton.
I know the rules of public disorder. I know what in plain situations are.
I want to say, Mark, how many times has Hatton attacked on the police in the corner? Hatton's been attacked several times. There's the problem. You don't deal with the people causing the problem. You deal with the victims of the problem. And until you start dealing with the people causing the problem, it's going to get worse and worse and worse. Until you start dealing with the problem, you've got to. Until you deal with the problem and the people that are causing the violence, it's going to get worse and worse and worse.
Please deal with the hornets. Don't deal with Hatton.
It might figuratively be euphemistic to open the hornets there, but the hornets need dealing with because they're the violent ones.
And I think that's a good simile to describe what we're all facing here. Deal with the hornets, not the person who's poking them within the rounds of free speech, within the rounds of Section 29J of the Public Order Act, which I hope you're aware of, which allows any ridicule or criticism on the basis of religion. It's very soundly detailed in the Public Order Act. In the House of Lords, they actually did some good when they added that section to the Public Order Act. She is working and behaving completely within the bounds of Section 29J. But there are some people that don't like it. And those people react violently. Deal with the violent people.
Well, no one's reacting violently yet, which I'm eternally grateful for.
Absolutely.
What I'm trying to do is prevent that this...
And don't do it by denying Section 29J. Nothing in the Public Order Act prevents criticism, ridicule.
That's the Public Order Act of 1886.
No, but Section 29J, you don't know about it. I can't believe you don't know about it. You're here for public order, and you don't know. I know Section 29J. And I think it only came in 2007, so it's not an old piece of law. You know, it's much more recent than Redmond Bay. And we all know the Redmond Bay case is another case which protested the right to offend. You don't know the Redmond Bay case either.
I'm a police officer, not a lawyer. I don't know the
answer. These are basic aspects of free speech.
That's true. I'm completely agree with you that when somebody, anybody, approaches into another demonstration. Uses any language that might be interpreted as threatening, abusive, or insulting, and causes harassment, alarm, or distress. That's when we breach, when we violate. Yes, I know, but
that is not possible.
It says at the beginning of it.
You are taking my freedom.
But that's the Public Order Act has greater value than that. That's the proceeds of all of the public order. It was added by the House of Lords.
Okay. I'm going to disagree with you there. I'm going to say that is
29
years.
You say you're not sure
what
in England.
I dare you, you've talked about the
Semitism. People do it here and you get I was aggressively asked last week. If you were Jew, you would have been asked before. I've never been asked before.
I'm going to
the police. And you're talking about
men. If you've been brought here for a public order,
there's one thing that I'll come away with this, However, I'm sure you can understand when people, when tempers are frayed, especially on a hot day,
I'll just think, when people approach you and say, oh, there's a guy over there.
I know there's two sides to every story as well, I do know that.
She's
been removed from the
social. Have you ever been charged with any
What does that mean? She's going to herself. I am not the one who is bringing people to attack me. I am not the one who is paying people from Scotland to bring it here. Don't play that game. Are you saying, oh, woman has been raped because she was wearing a skirt? What a stupid thing to say in front of the officer, and they just turn a blind eye because it's the freedom of speech. What a stupid thing. No one cares about my rights. Muslims cannot answer the basic question, what happens if, Mr. Policeman, please help us, we need your help. Why? Because we brought mess to ourselves by stating there are holes in the narrative, and we have no answer. Right now, all we can do is, Mr. Policeman, please help us. And thanks to God, Mr. Policeman is helping the protected group. They need very much help.
Anyway, we're leaving. Bye.
That's another issue.
Here's the problem. Almost a year ago, Muslims expressed that there are holes in the narrative, so don't take my nickel, please. Approximately a year ago, it was Muslims who told us there are holes in the narrative. All I am asking, fill the holes. It's been whole year with the Holy Quran. What Muslims do is, oh, Mr. Policeman, please help us. We can't answer the basic questions. Please rescue us. And Mr. Policeman comes, yeah? They need rescue. But the bottom line is this. Lord Jesus Christ rescued everyone. Yet today they are running away from me. What a disgraceful day for speakers for us. People turn up with their camera. They are quite happy to practice their freedom of speech. But I cannot practice my freedom of speech. Why? Because I am asking questions about Islam. Islam is so really, really awful ideology. No one can defend it. All they do is, Mr. Policeman, please defend Islam for us. You know what will happen when Islam takes over? This Mr. Policeman couldn't be very happy at all. He's not going to be happy. I'm not going to be happy. Because my rights, basic human rights, are going to be taken away from me. Because we are turning blind eye and deaf ears at the heart of freedom of speech.
What did the police tell you?
Well, I was causing problems and people are being offended. They didn't want to debate.
So he was keeping you away from him?
He was telling me to
approach you.